So I'm going to tell you all my reasons why I think you should go winter camping and why I think you're going to love it. Now, I'm probably just like most of you watching this video. I don't like to be cold and I don't like to be uncomfortable either. And those are really the two biggest obstacles to camping in the wintertime. One myth that I want to put to bed right away is that you have to spend thousands of dollars to be able to go winter camping so that you can be warm and you can be comfortable. But that's just not true. So don't give up on the idea of winter camping before you even hear why you should consider doing it. Just because you think, I can't afford it. Now, one of the reasons that winter camping is so pleasant is because your chances of running into other people is significantly lower. So if you prefer solitude, then winter camping is going to provide that for you. Remember, most people don't like to be cold and uncomfortable. And so they're not sure how to camp in the wintertime and be warm and comfortable at the same time. And sadly, most people are couch potatoes and they don't want to invest the time and the energy and the effort to go do something like winter camping. So you'll likely have the whole forest all to yourself, if you're into that kind of thing, which I definitely am. Another reason that winter camping is so great is you normally don't have to worry about any fire bans. So you can have a nice, pleasant campfire without worrying about starting a forest fire. You'd have to admit, there's few things that are more pleasant, more enjoyable, more relaxing than sitting around a campfire on a chilly winter evening. Another thing that's so great about winter camping is you're not typically going to have to worry about bears, especially them getting into your food at night. But you have to remember, that depends. It depends on what part of the country that you're in. If you're in a part of the country that's got a little bit more of a temperate climate, the bear's hibernation pattern isn't going to be the same as in the high mountains. Or if you live in an area where there's high mountains, if it's been unusually warm, then the hibernation patterns may have changed also. So you still could have an encounter with a bear, but the chances are really, really, really small. One of the best things about winter camping, no bugs, no flies crawling on your food while you're trying to eat, no mosquitoes just biting you constantly. So what more is there to say about that? No bugs. All right, another reason why I like winter camping probably isn't going to win me any points among a lot of you. Since there are far fewer people, there are far fewer dogs. Now, I don't mind it if people bring their dogs on hiking trips and camping trips and stuff like that, but what drives me absolutely crazy is when people just let their dog off leash and let the dog run wherever it feels like it. Now, in a lot of public lands, like wilderness areas, dogs aren't even allowed, whether on leash or off leash. Now, I don't know how many times a dog has come running up to me and put its nose in a personal part of my body or jumped up on me with muddy paws. I honestly don't appreciate that. Now, I know that a lot of dog owners think that they love their dog, so everybody else probably loves their dog too, but that's just not true. Another thing that you may not have thought about that makes winter camping so great is the fact that you don't have to worry about food spoiling. So you can take better food to eat on your trip. You don't have to try to survive on processed, dehydrated bags of dust that the outdoors companies try to pretend are real food and which hikers for some reason pretend that they actually enjoy eating. Now, I have a fairly high metabolism and I need a lot of calories, especially a lot of fat calories. So I like to eat real food instead of dehydrated meals in a bag. So by camping in the wintertime, you have natural refrigeration to keep your food from spoiling, so you can eat real food. Still another reason that winter camping is so great is you have your choice of camping spots. The likelihood of you going off to try to find your favorite spot and finding it occupied by other campers is going to be pretty small. Plus, you can really just kind of wander all over the woods and have your pick of where you want to set up camp. But I guess my biggest reason for enjoying winter camping so much is just to be able to prove to myself that I can do it, that I can actually accomplish something that's challenging, that's difficult, and that most other people don't want to do. Now, sure, there might just be an element of vanity and pride in that. There probably is, but I have to say it is pretty gratifying to be able to do something at my age that a lot of people half my age can't do. But there is that element of just competition with self. Can I do these difficult things? Can I do something challenging? Can I push myself beyond the limits of what maybe I normally would feel comfortable doing and feel safe doing? Whether it's a winter backpacking trip or a summer backpacking trip or even just a tent camping trip. I face that, just that same kind of laziness, inertia, just not want to actually get out there and do it. Maybe there's even some apprehensions on my part? You know, am I going to find a good place, and am I going to be uncomfortable there? Is the weather going to cooperate? Is it going to be too nasty for what I'm prepared for? So I still deal with all those same concerns and fears and apprehensions and misgivings every trip I take. It's not like, you know, I wake up in the morning thinking, all right, I get to go out winter camping. Oftentimes I wake up and it's the day that I'm supposed to leave and I'm like, ugh, I don't want to do this. I don't know if I can do this. But then there's that competing thought that goes on in my head. Am I going to conform to the stereotypical American ideal of sitting behind a desk all day and then going home and sitting in front of your TV until it's time to go to bed, and then you wake up in the morning and you do the same thing all over again? Plus, I've been hiking and backpacking and camping and hunting with my kids since a lot of them were just really little, and they still enjoy doing those kinds of things. And so by pushing myself and challenging myself to do these difficult things, I can still go out there and enjoy doing those things with them now that they're all adults. So those are my reasons why I think winter camping is so great. If you've got your own reasons why you like winter camping, leave those in the comments down below.